You're standing in a street in a British town in the late Victorian era. The old queen's still on the throne. It's a time between the old world and the new. It's a winter's night, cold and moonless. You should also imagine one more thing. There's electric streetlight. High off the ground, the lamp is flickering and hissing. Underneath the streetlight stands a woman. She has an intelligent, determined face and curly hair pinned in a mound on top of her head. She's staring up at the electric light. It's an arc lamp, a wisp of lightning crackling between two electrodes. She's listening to the hiss, noticing that when the arc buzzes, the light dims. She knows those lights throw off sparks. They can start fires. She's imagining a future where electric light could be bright, even, and safe. She's thinking, how can I make that happen? Hertha Marks Ayrton had always had to be ingenious. Born into a Jewish family in Portsmouth in 1854, her father was dead by the time she was seven, leaving the family with little more than a pile of debt. But Hertha Marks Ayrton was what you might call a bright spark, and always inventive. She was stubborn, tomboyish, and outspoken. Every evening for a year, after a full day of work, Marks Ayrton studied for the Cambridge University entrance exam. She passed in 1874 with honours in mathematics and English. She was an astonishingly hard worker and made her first recorded invention, a sphygmomanometer that would draw a graph of a person's pulse. After graduating, she carried on teaching and inventing. In 1888, she delivered a series of six hugely popular public lectures on electricity, in which she held out to her audience a compelling vision of an electrified future. Electric arc lights were used in street lamps. They provided incredibly bright lightning in a bottle. But they were volatile and poorly understood. To make them safe and reliable, someone needed to invent a way to precisely control their dangerous, temperamental power. So Hertha Marks Ayrton asked herself, why did arc lights flicker? And how could she stop them doing it? She put together an intricate and comprehensive set of experiments to test out every possibility. She often had to hold the arc steady by hand for 4 or 5 hours to get consistent results. And Marks Ayrton deduced the electric arc hissed when oxygen was present in small craters in the carbon's surface. The hiss was the sound of the carbon oxidising. To stop this happening, Hertha Marks Ayrton invented and patented a new kind of carbon rod, coated with a copper film to stop oxygen reaching the sides of the electrodes. As she predicted, this gave a steadier arc, a more dependable light. Hertha Marks Ayrton wanted to make streetlights safer, and she did. The arc light helped create a new after-dark world of working, playing, shopping and exploring. She ended up sparking life into detonators, 3D printing and maybe one day rocket launchers for space travel. Hertha Marks Ayrton tamed lightning. The arc that burned so brightly between the electrodes of those early lights was uncontrollable. A wisp of lightning, if you like. Marks Ayrton got that lightning under her control and gave it to the world.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed that, be sure to check out these videos next. And if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button and click the bell to get a notification each time we upload a new video.